glaube, 100 Tage alte Tore gemacht haben. Ja. Ja.
Thank you. you very much. Of course, the first piece you heard was America the Beautiful. That is the Carmen Dragon arranger. Carmen Dragon is actually a Hollywood arranger, and known for using some very unique harmonies and things in that. And that's what we actually consider to be the hardest version of that piece out there. It's extremely musical. Uses some really nice key signatures. It didn't sound that pretty the first time we played. It was anything but beautiful, but I think we did a great job on that. One of those things I'm thinking, we might start every concert with that one. It's just that good a piece of music. We're going to continue on now with Abram's Pursuit. If you weren't able to make it to the large group performance evaluation, any fancy word for a festival, we are, I'm not a proud man. Go around doing this like a lot of my colleagues up north do.
Well, I work for this school and we're level 6 and we do this and that.
Okay, that's great. Okay. We're a little swamp band and we play level 6 too. And we're pretty good at it, but we just wait to see them somewhere and then we outplay them when they get mad at us. They have to deal with it. But this next piece is actually one that they perform at the festival. It is a level 6 piece. You'll notice all you have to do is watch the flutes, watch the clarinets, watch the mallets, watch the percussion, you'll see why it's level 6. They play probably, 50, 60,000 notes inside this little song. It's a unique little piece. It's actually based on the story in the book of Genesis, as Abram was pursuing those who had captured Lot and his family. And this is David Holsinger's interpretation of the chase that occurs as they chase down those people to get them back. And it is a pursuit. Mark 176 beats a minute, and it never slows down. So we hope you enjoy Abram's Pursuit. The flute said, please watch the flute.
Thank you.
would ask if they could play that again. They all come like this after that one. That was a real, real workout. Great piece of music, and this goes to show you don't have to be from the fancy schools. You just gotta have the desire to do it. You know, the work that you get it done. And, these guys did a tremendous job at the end. They did a tremendous job at the festival with it. The judges were super complimentary. I told the middle school group this the other night at their concert. The head judge told me, he said, you know what you guys are doing is very unusual. He said, we wish it were usual, but it's very unusual to hear groups nowadays that can play like that, especially small schools. You know, so we're very fortunate. I appreciate the work that the kids put into it. Of course, I wouldn't have it any other way. I was just a stuff on them after we were done with it at the festival, and we pulled it back out a couple weeks later and start working again. I got to the grindstone, and that's relentless. But it's fun to have a group that can do it. Really, it's, you can do a lot of stuff. And speaking of doing a lot of stuff, this next piece, Hymn of St. Francis. Well, St. Francis, of course, is the patron saint of animals, nature, and Daniel Butvich wrote this piece. It's actually a multi-movement piece. It actually has 8 movements. You see in your program, we're only going to do a few movements. I saw somebody going 1, 2, 3, 7. And we're just doing the first, second, third, and 7th movement from this. And what this is you'll hear in the first movement, you'll actually hear a hymn that's played by a trumpet to start with. Eventually, the entire band will come in with the hymn. And this is kind of his idea of what it would be like if various animals were to participate in the singing or playing or whatever you want to call it of this hymn. So the first one, a murmuration of starlings. And starlings, of course, are birds. So you'll hear some birds in there. The second one, the scuttle of crabs, is a humorous attempt at what it would be like if crabs actually could make musical sounds. I think you'll like it. Hopefully we've got some extra noise going on here. You'll hear all the special little sound effects that are going on. So keep your eyes around the band. You'll see some different things going on, especially in the percussion section. Especially on the third movement, the Squabble of Seagull. You'll see them doing a lot of unusual things that if they did otherwise, they'd get yelled at for doing it. But in this piece, they're actually encouraged to do it. I will warn you right now about Squabble of Seagulls. Don't come looking for a melody. Don't come looking for something to tap your foot to. It's what it says. It's a squabble of seagulls. And then the last one we'll do for you is a rumba of rattlesnakes. So we hope you enjoy our movements of Hymn of St. Francis.
Thank you. Welcome to Crystal's concert.
Really?
Yeah, all three songs, same way. Sure. Yeah. Well, okay. Daphne get one drum a piece.
No, she's on something else.
It sounds about the same the first time, I'm telling you. So we're going to hold my board, you can do with that. We're going to go back to some real music now and go into a piece called Into the Raging River. I'd like to give the seniors a chance now to choose a song that they've done in the past and play on their final concert. And they chose a piece they did, was it freshman year? Their freshman year for a festival, Into the Raging River. By Stephen Reinke, and this is a tone poem. I'll actually try and paint a picture for you of what it's like in the rafting. Been rafting, we'll hear everything and go, yeah, I remember those moments. Never been rafting, we're going to start with the early morning arrival on the water. As you get ready to get in, the sun's coming through, starting to sparkle on the water just a little bit. You'll notice when the boat gets put in the water, you start to flow downstream a little bit. Things will just kind of roll along, nice, easy thing. And then, of course, as we know, if you go, anytime you go on a raft, there's a chance you might run into some rapids. You will. You'll definitely know when that comes up, when you go over the falls, and then the victorious finish if you survive the trip. So we hope you enjoy Into the Raging River. Thank you.
everyone for coming out and supporting the band, and we thank you for your support throughout the year. At this time, we would like to recognize our seniors in the symphonic band. As we call your name, we all please come up. We have a good time here. We all thank you for all your dedication to the band. Ayanna Bates. Caleb Murray.
Once again, thank you for coming out. We hope that you've enjoyed it. Please spread the word about what these guys do. It's really, if you get a chance to go listen to some other groups in South Georgia, I don't brag, but I've been told by other people that I trust. you'd really be amazed at what these guys are doing. They really do an incredible job. Can't be prouder of them. That's what we got this concert, but we gonna play. You got a group like this, they gonna play two songs and we going home. We gonna play. They always want to get tired, but that's okay. I like it. So. We hope that you've enjoyed it. Remind you that the banquet is Saturday, starts at 5:00, First Baptist. We also need your hats, your child's hat and pants back, ASAP, so we get all that set up and ready to go for summer. We'll get your notices out. Meetings and all that's going to happen during the summertime. All my rookies that are here, or seventh graders that are here, next year, remember, rookie camp starts Monday, 3:30 to 5 at Bethune. It's Monday and Tuesday. Percussion auditions are here Monday and Tuesday from 3:30 to 5. So percussionists will be here except for Pitt. Thank you. If there are any Pitt, seventh grade Pitt here, you'll be over there learning the march. We've got you taken care of, so we work about your feet first. So once again, rookie camp will be at Bethune Monday and Tuesday, and percussion auditions will be here. The last piece we're going to play for you, it's not going to take very long, hopefully. All right. It's entitled Gallop to End All Gallops. A gallop is a very fast march, and this is the one written to end all the other ones. So it's marked at 184 beats a minute. Sometimes we do that. Sometimes we manage to find 150. And so we hope we'll get through this. I think I told them that to choose either this one last or America last. And they didn't remember how the horses left to get through America. So we appreciate you coming out tonight and supporting us. And we look forward to many more years with you. And we hope that you enjoy a gallop to end all gallops.
The song no longer than 2 minutes.
Am I right?